How long has it been since I've talked about Dragon Ball Z? So, if you guys follow me on Instagram, you know that I finished Naruto Shippuden about 3 months ago. Finally, I understand all of the memes on my timeline. Except all of those memes about Sakura being useless. I mean, I get it. In Naruto, she trails far behind her peers, but over the course of the series, her growth is crazy. She's instrumental to the progression of the story, and by the end of the series, she's very well respected. I get as a main character, she's not as strong as everyone else, but that's never stopped out before. Think of someone like Krillin, for example. Krillin is by far one of the most useless main characters in anime. But for some reason, I never hear y'all talk about Krillin the way that y'all talk about Sakura. Which is crazy because he sets the standard for uselessness. So today, my friends, I want to talk about Sakura being way more useful than Krillin. Now, let's start with the basics. Despite Krillin training his entire life with the second strongest man in the multiverse, because let's face it, Goku is not stronger than Jiren, Krillin never gets a W. I mean, unless you count him bagging that robot with PTSD. Yo, this man had the power to wish for anything in the entire world, and he wished for his sex doll to get lady parts. And y'all calling Sakura useless? But besides that, Krillin has a zero on the body count list. Sakura killed one of the strongest members of the biggest game in Naruto with her bare hands. The only time that Krillin got a W was when he beat those little dogs that Nappa and Vegeta brought to Earth. And if I'm being real, Krillin actually helps a bunch of villains by showing them his signature move, the Destructo Disc. Because let's face it, every time Krillin uses it, he either misses or the villain just eats it. And then they immediately use it themselves. Like, oh, I didn't know that you could put your energy blast flat so I can cut people in half. Thanks, Krillin. The only time I can think of Krillin being useful is when he turned into chocolate and was used as sustenance. Sakura, on the other hand, does way more. She becomes the top medical ninja in the strongest village in the land without coming from a strong bloodline or inherited some special jutsu. She bags arguably the strongest ninja in the world with the greatest weapon of all, unrelenting persistence. During the Great Ninja War, she's on the front line getting busy. And let's not forget, Sakura begins to store her power in her forehead like Sonata. So all of the things that she's achieving in the later half of the series is at a fraction of her strength. Most importantly, unlike Krillin, she only dies once. Krillin dies 5 times. Like, damn. Get the hint. My girl Bulma shows up to all of the fights without any skills in martial arts, and she never once gets clapped. But y'all still stuck on Sakura, who couldn't match up with someone from a legendary bloodline and someone who has a nine-tailed beast inside of him. Okay. But do you agree? Let me know in my comments below. Until next time, have a fantastic week, my friends.